want to tell the story or shall I?
I think you should start the story.
Well, we met at, I was out on, at a bachelorette party for my sister's sister-in-law. And we all got ready at like the Marriott Hotel over there on West Shore. And we all got ready and we went downstairs in the lobby and we were all gonna take a picture, a group photo. And there was some gentlemen sit over yonder and I just walked up with the camera. Well, one of y'all take our picture very politely. And one of them did, got up, took our picture very nicely.
Not me.
It wasn't him, actually. No, it wasn't him. So then we go to dinner, and then after dinner we're going to the Blue Martini. And as I'm walking, we're walking down Bay Street, he came out of Bar Louie and approached me and was like, oh, hey, ladies, you're the one from the lobby at the hotel. And I was like, oh my gosh, what a small world. What are you guys up to? You should come join us. And it was, the Rays were in the playoffs at the time, so they were all sitting there watching the game. So once the game was over, they all came over and joined us, and we kind of just started talking and really hit it off.
By talking, she means kissing.
By talking, I mean kissing.
With Elena, it's just her zest for life, her always positive attitude, her sense of humor, her beauty. All this comes from the inside and just happens to show up on the outside, as I've learned over the years. Definitely. Her just intelligence, so many things.
Oh, I have to go with your kindness and your generosity is what sticks out. He's just the most wonderfully nice person and generous to anybody that he meets. And maybe not at first, but after he gets to know them.
The lies are coming out now.
You know, once he gets to know you, he's so...
Selectively,
he'll give you the shirt off his back. He really will.
It's passion. It's the Italian thing. It's that connection. It's love. It's all those things. Oh, that was a fantastic story. So can I lead into this one?
Yeah.
Yeah. You are editing this, right? Can I? Okay, good. Because that was 4 years, right? I'm just saying.
3 years.
3 years. Oh, I always messed the number up. And you can leave that in for laughter if you want, because I do. No, it was our 3-year anniversary. I remember this well now, and I'll tell you why. But anyhow, so we met, we declared the 18th our kind of month anniversary throughout the relationship. So it's been a theme.
It was October 18th when we met.
Was her, you know, friend's bachelorette party. So we marked that as the day of the relationship. So 3-year anniversary, we go to Burns Steakhouse, you know, and she figures we're just out to celebrate our anniversary, have a nice dinner, and I keep it on the down low all dinner long. We go up to the dessert room, we have dessert, it's all cool, nothing to see here. And I did the traditional thing. I got down on one knee and, you know, gave her a ring, hopefully worthy of her finger. And my God, she said yes, so I got enough alcohol into her that night. So mission accomplished there, because if it weren't for that, no, it was magical. It was magical and funny too, because people came by and said congratulations and all that. It was very memorable. How do you remember it?
Exactly like that, actually.
Yeah, she didn't see it coming. It was true surprise.
No, I mean,
I almost got busted. I almost got busted because I had the ring in a jacket and I had a little bulge in there. And she's like, well, what's that? Oh, it's my car keys.
No, you said it was the tag.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, I forgot to pull the tag out.
Some nonsense excuse, because I was that close to getting busted before I was out the door of the house. And fortunately, it worked out. And here we are, my God, almost a year and a half later.
Later, yeah.
If you can believe that.
I know.
I had a business trip. I had to go to San Francisco. And on our first date, which was a week later from when we met, I invited her to come along. She said she had never been.
She took. Did you say San Francisco?
San Francisco, yeah.
I didn't hear you say San Francisco.
I'm pretty sure I did. I may not have. That can be corrected in post.
Yeah, we did. Yeah, he invited me to San Francisco, and I was like, sure, I'll go, but, and I made jokes, you're not gonna cut me up in little pieces and leave me there, are you?
Couldn't promise anything at the time, but it was coming off the cannibalism, so. And we got through it. San Francisco is a weird town.
It was definitely a wonderful trip, and I would have to say we fell in love on that trip, right?
I think if that early in a relationship, you can stand a week in a hotel with each other, only merely 2 months in, that's a good sign.
Yeah.
right? You know, so it was definitely something that I think forever sort of bonded us together. Yeah, definitely.
And we chose this area, this spot tonight because it was what, our third date? We
went
to Ceviche's. We had our third date at Ceviche's over here, and after we had dinner, we took a very nice long walk all the way down here, and we ended up at the Vinoy, and we had some cocktails and after dinner drinks, if you will, and we kind of snuck up on their rooftop, and you know, we kind of kissed and was looking at the lights of the pier over behind us, and they were changing colors every, you know, few minutes. It was a different color. It was like the horse of the changing colors. And so it's always been kind of a special place for us coming out here. Because I have to say, when I was kissing him on the rooftop up there, I was thinking to myself, I could spend the rest of my life with him. So. And then we went to San Francisco shortly after. So that's really the story of us.
That is the simple version of it. There's no, yeah, nothing crazy.
Definitely had some moments between then and now.
We've experienced a lot of life. We've had a lot of challenges. I mean, I think those things have brought us together too.
Yeah.
Definitely over the years. Mm-hmm. Just things going on in our lives, helping each other out, you know how it is.
Yep. He built his own business while we've been together.
Well, she inspired me to try. Yeah.
Yeah.
The true definition of one's better half. What more is there to say? This is it.